No lie, Courage the Cowardly Dog is definitely a great show, bro. Maybe even top five. But bro, the villains in this show are wild. Like, they're not bad villains. They're great villains. Don't get me wrong. But bro, they were weird looking, bro. But I guess that was the whole point of the show. And they actually did a very good job at it, too. So today, we're going to be going over some of the villains in Courage the Cowardly Dog. Well, do we really call them villains? I guess we can. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and follow my TikTok at Pete Jared. And let's get straight into the video.
You two are a cozy corner of the world.
Not gonna lie, bro, we gotta pause right here. But bro, just look at this guy, bro. You think I'm finna let him in my house? Now, I get he may be a family friend, but bro, I wouldn't be friends with him even if I had to.
Holiday.
As soon as I see bro smiling like that, say goodbye.
Like, nah, bro, you gotta go.
Like, he has to have one of the devious smiles known to man, bro. Just look at his smile. If that doesn't creep you out, I don't know what does.
Like, just look at how he's looking at Courage, bro.
Look how afraid Courage is. Like, bro, get this man out of the house now.
Now, there's a lot of things wrong with this scene. First of all, why did y'all let this man Courage? I'm sorry, I just got so hot for a second. Why did y'all let this man Courage in a bathroom with this man and lock the door?
Like, Courage don't even need a cut right now. He look fresh. My dog look crispy.
And you see how Courage tried to run and bro pulled him back, bro. I'm not gonna lie, that was funny.
Alright, bro, not gonna lie, this might be the first time they missed with a villain. Cause I'm not gonna lie, bro, what is that?
Like, who thought of this, bro? Who thought of making the character?
Well, let me not say that. The character was good, but like the execution, bro.
Like, they really, alright, I get the show came out a while ago, but they could have did way better, bro.
He doesn't even look like he belongs in the show for real.
Return the slab.
What?
Return the slab. Or suffer my curse.
What's your offer?
This night, you will be visited by three plagues, each worse than the last. Return the slab.
Not gonna lie, bro, the voice isn't making it any better. But I definitely need to go way deeper into this episode because it was a great episode. So probably another video, I'm gonna go over this episode because y'all need to see this too. Yo, this dude is a hater, bro.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but I think his name D Lung or something like that.
But he did not have to kick Courage like that, bro. That just made me heat up. Bro, and the thing is, the most random things be in this show.
Like, where did they just fall into?
And why is that in the sewer? Like, I have so many questions that need answers.
Save us. I think we're getting digested.
Yes, in a pool of my stomach acid. All this careless, selfish behavior.
Wait a minute, who is that talking?
People selling themselves.
What is that?
Oh my goodness, there's no way it gets any worse than that, bro. What even is that?
Bro, oh my gosh, I'm speechless right now.
Like, why is he just under the sewer?
And it's crazy because it's actually a good villain.
I'm not gonna lie, bro. I expect nothing less from this show at this point. I promise you, I would have had the same reaction as Courage.
Because why is there just a white floating head in my basement? But then again, they are in the middle of nowhere. Matter of fact, I need to figure out who wanted to live there. It's not even a good house.
And you would think after all of the stuff that happened, they'd want to leave.
Nope, they were there the whole show. All the seasons, they were there.
Well, matter of fact, it probably wasn't even just where they lived, bro. Because in the city, stuff was happening too. Like, you just seen the monster in the sewer.
Alright, bro, that was the last straw. No, this is the last straw.
What is that?
And not gonna lie, somebody can actually inform me on this episode because I don't know if I could classify this as a villain because I don't remember this episode that much. I just know it's a weird looking thing on this show, bro, and it's just weird. It's weird, it's weird, it's weird.
Like, Courage the Cowardly Dog was a very weird show, but weird in a good way.
Something bad is going to happen. Huh?
Oh,
Not gonna lie, bro, this was the last thing I was expecting. This might be the first time I actually got jump scared by a cartoon, bro, because what is that? Like, you, bruh, oh my gosh, imagine as a kid watching that, bro.
Like, you actually think it's a girl playing a violin and then you just get clapped on, bruh?
That will give me eternal traumatization. I don't even know what traumatization is a word. It probably is, though. It sounded right. But in conclusion, man, Courage the Cowardly Dog is definitely one of the best shows out there. From the villains, to Courage, to Eustace, to Muriel, everything is just great. And it's definitely top 5 certified for me. But now I got a question for y'all. Which show do y'all think had the more weirder villains? Regular Show or Courage the Cowardly Dog? Fluff it. I'ma throw Gravity Falls up there too. But other than that, thanks for watching. Follow me on TikTok at Peak Jared. Like, comment, subscribe, and follow me on Twitter too at Peak Jared 1. I be active on there a little bit. And follow me on Instagram, Peak Jared 10. And I'm out. You lost because I ain't with it. We gon' pull the red 7-7. Think about winners, it's 10-10.